give you a walkthrough what all we are going to learn this training program. How does it add value to your career? How does it benefit to your career? So the training program is divided into various modules. And there are two trainers are involved into this. The training program consists of three modules. The module first will talk about HFM financial management, HFM implementation point of view. There are total 22 sessions for HFM financial management. And then in module 2, we'll discuss about FDQM, financial data quality management, how data pull from different sources. There are total 15 sessions for HFM. HFM and FDQM session may go in parallel or maybe in sequence. The idea is to complete the course in 1 month, so accordingly we plan. We have a module 3rd and 4th. In module 3rd, we'll discuss about statutory reporting and financial reporting. And financial reporting using HFM financial management. HFM financial reporting. And in module 4, we'll talk about desktop-based reporting using Smart View. Ad hoc and management reporting using Smart View. This is a 4-module program. It is assumed you know the basics of accounting and finance. However, if you are absolutely technical and no exposure to this, we would provide you self-learning accounting videos, accounting and financial videos, which will help you to understand the important jargons, keywords and jargons one should know before starting the HFM. So all there are close to 10 hours training program on self-learning accounting and financial basics fundamentals. This is what is going to be provided. The duration of the training program would be close to 36 hours to 40 hours. We would have a session. This is a weekend training program. This batch, the weekend, because we have a people from disparate time zone. We have a people from UK time zone and US. That would be midnight for them. So this batch would be a weekend program. We do have a weekdays classes as well, but this batch would be 7 p.m. IST, which is 9:30 a.m. EST, Saturday and Sunday. HFM class would be weekend, and FDQM class may be weekend or weekdays, depends upon your mutual availability with the trainer. It would be 150-minute session every day, every Saturday and Sunday. So we cover 5 hours training program in 1 weekend for 5 weekends. HFR would have 2 sessions. SmartView would also have a 2 sessions. HFR would have 2 extended sessions. SmartView would have 2 sessions where we see how people can pull data from different sources and design the reports. So that's a training program duration. Regarding practice, how do you practice? So there are 2 ways. We provide you installation video, HFM environment for practice. So we'll provide you this possibility. We'll provide you installation video. Installation video will consist of everything, and installation video and PDF in case you like to install on your own. We also provide you a VM image which you can use, which consists of your HFM and all the required stuff, HFM, HFM, FDQM and financial report. Naturally it has a smart view as well. So we provide you pre-built image. You need to download and plug in, no configuration required. It's naturally it's an image, so a pretty bulky. So practice, we strongly recommend people to practice along with us, and we understand the actual learning lies in practice. The more you practice, the more you learn. So VM would be provided as part of this. A learning material, we provide our own learning material. We have a content development team in BISP. In fact, the consultant who are on bench, who do not have any project, so we ask them to document their knowledge. As a result of this, we have got very huge learning material. Okay, and there are many case studies as well. So we provide you student guide, which walk you through step by step, provide you lab guide, and we provide you practice application. A practice application is a customized sample application which we added couple of real-time scenarios. It's a practice application which comes with HFM, but we have customized to the greater extent and incorporated many real-time contents, like we have added financial elements, various business rules, minority interests, ownership management, equity pickup, many rules we have added over here in this exam. So you will have practice application. We will give you practice application, application and the video, how to set up the practice application. So right from the first day, you can put the application into your environment and you can practice along with us. We do have a missing class policy. We do understand, as part of your consulting activity, you may need to travel. So, and we want to make sure that training should be productive for the people at the end of the day. It should be true value of your money. So as per missing class policy, if you miss one or two, few missing classes, as it's a weekend training program, each class would be very lengthy. So if you miss one class, one or two classes, missing classes, you can communicate to us. We'll provide you recorded session for the missing class. However, if you miss many classes in a row and you think you have to travel for the job or assignment or blah blah blah, you need to complete drop off, or you miss many classes and you're finding difficult to cope up, so you can retake the classes, retake the training in upcoming batches. You can retake training in any batch up to next 6 months, and you don't have to pay anything extra for this. So that's a facility we provide you at no cost. You miss the classes, you should be able to make use of your time and money eventually. So that's a missing class policy. So that's a brief about the training program. If anybody has any question, can ask me before you proceed further about the technical architecture and what is HFM all about. So today's session, we're going to talk about what are the problem and challenges. Why do we need HFM financial management? What is financial management? And a typical scenario of monthly or quarterly closing process, financial consolidation, and finally we'll talk about advantages of HFM. So let's go through the formal definition of HFM. See, HFM financial management is a completely a web-based solution that design, I would underline all the important term, it's a comprehensive, it's a web-based application that enable enterprise financial management. Enterprise, it means HFM is not implement at departmental level, it implement for an enterprise, one solution for the entire organization. Unlike we implement HFM of one department or one line of business, it's enterprise financial information. How does it add value? Primarily, HFM speed up your activity quickly and cost effectively. Eventually, whatever activity you do, financial consolidation is required in every organization, right from a small grocery shop to big enterprise. How does HFM add value? It make it fast and cost effective. I'll come to that point. How come it is cost effective? So financial management delivers the global data collection. So data collects from different sources, the data is in disparate format, data come from your some legacy application like mainframe, some ERP, PeopleSoft, SAP, JD Edward, or it may be semi-structured data, flat file, Excel sheet, different data sources. So collect data from different sources. We have a tool called FDQM, a dedicated data collection tool. Collect, financial consolidate, and eventually you create a report on this. So collect, consolidate, and report. And you do analysis over here. But in HFM, the analysis is confined to the, we cannot do very rich analysis in HFM. Therefore, the data export from HFM in turn to SBase or some third-party application where you can do financial analysis. That's called financial intelligence. It helps financial managers the ability to rapidly close financial report, financial results, and global regulatory requirements. So now, first I would underline what does financial consolidation mean. A simple example. So in order to simulate this, we have prepared a couple of Excel sheets. The first sheet talk about what does financial consolidation, and then I further take this to different kind of consolidation rules. Now this sheet talk about, I have some kind of expenses associated with organization structure. So my organization structure is line of business, sub-line of business, and division. Right, and these are various kind of expenses. So I've got two sheets for the similar data. Sheet 1 called risk assessments group, and sheet 2 is risk mitigation group. They are two Excel sheets. If you look at them carefully, they're absolutely identical, absolutely same, except their organization structure is different. So this is my organization structure for first sheet and second one. So if you look at carefully, my second, the line of business same, sub line of business is same, the division got changed. So actually this is my two division, there are two Excel sheet which representing two division of an organization, and these are the expenses associated with two division. These all expenses pertaining to meeting expenses. When I simply say consolidation, consolidation means adding up the numbers. So when I say total accommodation expense would be sum of this value, total accommodation expense 58,000 over here for this entity and 58,000 for another entity, another division, right? So my total accommodation expenses would be 58 plus 50 in a simple mathematics if I take. So when I say total accommodation expense for my subline of business would be 58 plus 58, the total accommodation expenses. So consolidation is adding up the number, but consolidation, financial consolidation is much more beyond that. We not only add the numbers, we also follow various compliance and consolidation rule, financial consolidation rule. So in simple word, in as per this example, my organization structure is, I've got line of business, then I've got sub line of business, this is my hierarchy, and there are two division, division 1 risk assessment group and division 2 risk mitigation, and my total expenses pertaining to accommodation expenses would be sum of these two numbers. So my accommodation expense is 58 plus 58,000. That's a basic consolidation rule. Now, but when you consolidate, you also follow various accounting principle. A simple example of consolidation principle, we can add a minority interest or ownership percentage. So for example, in this case we did not apply any kind of ownership percentage, and we say 100% consolidate to the parent. Let's take a typical scenario, a franchisee model, or you distribute your business partners. So a parent organization, this is my organization structure. The organization structure, I have a parent, called line of business. Under this, there are two children. These are two entities, A, B, C, D. Now, A entity is a company-owned entity, A and B, whereas C is a franchise. They are franchise, they are not company-owned, they are business partners. So, when you talk about in terms of revenue, when you say total revenue is the sum of, total revenue of line of business is the sum of all the entities. But when it's a company-owned, they contribute 100% of the revenue, whereas franchise contribute only 30% of the revenue. So this is basically a royalty which they pay, a revenue they pay as a royalty. A typical, a very common example. So when you add up the number, so for example, the numbers are simple, 100, 100, 100. A simple consolidation would be 400, but when you apply ownership percentage, it will be 200 plus 60. It will be 100, 100, and 30 and 30 over here. So output would be 260. As expected, against 400, output is 260. So this is a simple consolidation rule associated with your while you consolidate the numbers. There are many rules, such rules apply in this. You can also enable and disable the entity. So for out of these four entity, you can attach a flag and say, in the month of January, one of my entities sunset or it is inoperational. So we can attach a flag, active or inactive flag. So whichever entities are active, only those entity will consolidate. Inactive entities will not consolidate. So my output would be rather than suppose the 100, 100, 100, this time output would be only 200 because my other two entities are not consolidating. So only active entity would consolidate, so output would be 200. So many such rules are applied when you consolidate your number. That's a typical simple example for consolidation. Now, I would first show you the complete financial closing cycle. And then how does HFM product family meet or the products are matched according to it. So in a typical financial consolidation cycle, you must have heard about organization. Some company has published their quarterly closing reports or half year closing reports. What does our quarterly closing report consist of? So all organization do the financial closing. So which consists of, they collect data from different sources and data required to be cleansing. Because data required to be cleansing, the data come from disparate sources, different format, different compliance, different currencies, different format, required to be clean. So collection of data and data cleansing is done by a tool called HFM Financial Data Quality Management, FDM or FDQM. The one tool which is responsible data collection, collection and cleansing. FDQM is also used these days to pull data from your ERP system. You can directly connect with your Oracle E-Business Suite and retrieve and write back, push down as well. So collect directly with the ERP system, pull the data from there and write back. Then you have a consolidation. The consolidation, once you retrieve the data and you have a high faith or trust on numbers, then you can consolidate them using HFM Financial Management. Second step. Step first, step second. Step third, you do the internal reporting. When I say internal reporting, it is for internal management. And when you do internal reporting, you don't have any compliance, don't have any format, specific format. It's your own defined rules, organization defined rules. A simple example, maybe you like to do some kind of analysis, like product profitability analysis, customer retention, some kind of analysis or trending you would like to do, internal reporting can be done with a very elegant solution these days called SmartView and widely used. This enable your business user to create report on their own. People want these days drag and drop and quickly process the data. The idea is to enable them to focus on their business rather than on the technology. So anybody who knows the business idea and how to use Excel sheet can quickly drag and drop and create smart view reports. More often for your functional and business users. So then you do the internal reporting. Intercompany transaction, all these are internal reporting. Then you have an external reporting for government bodies and statutory organization. Like in US, we create the report external reporting using various compliance to the Security Exchange Commission. In India, we have a SEBI. There are various compliances need to follow. We need the financial reporting. The four-step operation, and in order to do four different operation, there are four different products, and they provide a one cumulated solution, financial closing solution. Now, how does HFM fit into this picture? If you look at the HFM financial management, this is the architecture. You see, you have a three-tier, client tier, application database tier. The client tier, we have got a desktop client called Excel spreadsheet, which is a smart view. There's an icon called HFM or HFM icon up here over here. I think it is not installed in my system. A HFM icon up here, which says people can directly connect to HFM, pull data and do all consolidation analysis activity. You see, so remaining in Excel sheet, people can do everything. That's called smart view. There's a client tier. So you have a client tier in Excel with a smart view. You also have a browser based, a web based client tier where you can perform various activity. So that's a browser based client tier. You log into your browser, your workspace, and you can open your application. Then you have an application tier. Your application tier is responsible to connect your client tier with your database tier, and all the rendering of the request is done in application tier. You see, you have a different application server. The first server, in case you are working in EPMA application, there are two kind of application in HFM. A classic for a legacy application, people who are migrating from previous version, and EPMA, which is Oracle recommended. So in case you are using EPMA application, we have a application server called Dimension Architect Server, Architect Dimension Server called EPMA Server. And we have a financial management server, middle tier, and web tier. Now the latest release 11.1.2 onwards, all web tier is deployed in WebLogic. Prior to this, it was deployed in Tomcat. So complete deployment of middle tier application done on web server is your WebLogic server. It's a part of Fusion middleware architecture now. Therefore, there is a tightly coupled with your various Oracle product like Oracle PeopleSoft or Oracle EBS or subsequent in JD Edward as well. So it's a part of Fusion middleware architecture now. The latest release is 11.2.1.2.3, that's called PS3. I think April 30 it is released, 2 months before. And the finally you have a database tier. So HFM is an application, so it is just an interface, the data stored in underlying relational database. Underlying relational database, so whatever data you store is stored in your relational tables, but how data store in underlying which table, these are not documented. Even you know, as part of the learning, I can tell you what are the dimension tables, what are different tables, and data structure where data stores. So primarily there you have got two kind of database, HFM financial management and architect. HFM database is actually store your business data and metadata, whereas Architect RDBMS store the metadata, your dimension, your members and all information stored over here. So that's a typical architecture of HFM financial management. I like to show you a quick view about HFM financial management, quick browser view. So I was talking about consolidation. So typical consolidation works is like in this context. I have a parent entity called California. It's got two children, Sunnyvale and Foster City. A simple consolidation would be I take some entity. For example, I consolidate my various sales, total sales for California and Sunnyvale and Foster City, will add them and consolidate to the parent. This is a typical consolidation. I assume both of them have the same currency and a total sales. It's administration expenses. So my total administration expenses would be sum of your Sunnyvale and Foster City, the typical sum. However, there's no accounting principle or consolidation rules are applied. In another instance, we apply some consolidation rule. And you see, the total administration expenses should be sum of Sunnyvale and Foster City. So your expected output would be 500, but it is 200 only, because here I apply a consolidation rule and one of my entities inactive. You see, my entity is inactive. Sunnyvale is inactive. Therefore, when I consolidate, Sunnyvale is not going to participate into consolidation. I can also apply consolidation percentage. For example, I make it active now and define the consolidation percentage. 30% value would be consolidated to the parent. Save. I need to log out and log in again. My session got expired. So from here we can define how consolidation take place. So for this intersection, I enable the entity consolidation and define the consolidation percentage. 30% PCON percent consolidation and save it. So as per your consolidation rule, when I refresh and consolidate now, the output will be different. Right click and consolidate. The output is 290. Why? 200 plus 30% of 300 is 290. So it's not a typical consolidation. Consolidation does not mean just adding up the number. It means when you add up the number, you also look what are the rules are associated with this. A simple example for consolidation. Now HFM, as I said, has got internal reporting. There are many internal reporting examples. We'll talk about in greater detail subsequently. But HFM ship along with some basic reporting facilities, features. Like in this example, I have an intercompany report. This is for internal management. Intercompany, as the name indicates, a transaction happened between two entities of an organization. That's called intercompany. We can do an inbuilt report with the intercompany. For example, I like to see any transaction happen between two entities of an organization. So I can pick up an entity and I say, is there any transaction happen between Sunnyvale and Foster City? It's like your transaction between your left pocket and right pocket. As simple as that. So this internal intercompany transaction is not for external reporting, it's for internal management. So any transaction happened between these two entities, we can build a report over here. That's a simple example which demonstrates HFM also has a reporting capabilities. Not to that extent, actual professional reports and reports are designed in your HFM financial reporting tool. Or these are, you can connect HFM with OBIE and create extensive, sophisticated financial consolidation report. Next bigger question. Many of these things I shown you can be done in ERP as well. There are many ERP tools which can do this activity. How does HFM adds a value? So HFM adds value with various contacts. One simple thing I can show you. Your typical ERP tool store data in a transactional manner. Data stored in a transactional table. That's the simplest example what I show you in my Excel sheet. Data stored in Excel sheet. If you see this example, data is stored in transactional reporting format. So one row is one transaction. If you read it complete, the one transaction happened between a country. So it's like it's a wall data example of Walmart data, where customer go to the shop, buy something. The system they use is called transactional system, and the way they store the data is like in which country, which city the store is located, the address of the store, what product the customer has bought, which date, what was the store information, who was the store manager, store type, and various other facts like sales, operating expenses, shipping cost, and blah blah blah. So your typical ERP tool store data in a tabular format in terms of tables. HFM also store data in tables, but the logical presentation of data in HFM is in terms of subcube. So it's a subcube structure you call ROLAP, relational OLAP. The data stored physically in relational table, but the organization of data is in terms of subcube structure. What is OLAP? What is subcube structure? I've already talked about this in my one of the demo videos. It is assumed you know about it. If you do not know, we'll share across a self-learning video about subcube and ROLAP. So HFM store data in subcube structure. The benefit of storing data in subcube, you can actually make use of business intelligence on top of this. So this has become a financial intelligence. Data stored in subcube structure, so we can make use of actually OLAP functionality, or you can create a cross tabular reports and OLAP functionality. So you see in this example, every time you access the data, you access the intersection of dimension members. Data is presented, stored in terms of dimension and facts, as compared to your ERP tool with data stored in terms of tabular view. Tables, data is considered to be a dimension view over here. So we can make use of OLAP functionality, and sophisticated BI reporting can be created on top of HFM. So typically you access the data in the intersection of dimension members. So HFM comes up with a pre-built dimension structure. There are 8 predefined dimensions and 4 custom defined dimension, pre-built dimension structure. So how it works, that's one major difference between your typical ERP tool and your HFM. As I said, what you can do with HFM, without HFM also financial consolidation happen, but how does HFM add value? The overall product collection, product suite, it saves your time. So this is an example for how typical consolidation process work. A consolidation process starts with collecting data from different sources, and the collection of data takes 6 days. A typical example, 6 days means you have a organizational data in different format, different currencies, different accounts, different relational database tables, semi-structured data. You have a challenges in multiple parts in terms of technology, in terms of functional. So it takes extensive time to collect data from different sources, and typical time is 6 days, which is reduced over here by less than 2 days, because it's an automated process now. You can connect your FDQM with your relational database or ERP tool and directly pull data from there. So overall process saves your 4 days. Then once your data collected, you need to perform various kind of adjustment, intercompany adjustment, currency conversion, various other adjustment which your financial department directs you. Different kind of adjustment require accrual method. So all this adjustment take another 6 days, which is reduced to a 4 days over here. Including reporting, it takes 6 days. So overall, our consolidation process completes in 6 days. Even for a big banking system, the complete consolidation process 6 days. So the cost saving is actually in terms of time. You get more time for data analysis, and that's a reason a lot of financial intelligence can be implemented in these days. These days we have a concept called balance sheet planning. We can also forecast our balance sheet. We can forecast our expenses, profits and loss, and complex CFE cash flow engine calculation can be performed, and projection of the data on financial data can be done because people have accurate data and they have more time to do analysis. In the previous example, your actual financial analyst, budget administrator or financial controller are occupied in correcting data rather than they spend their time in projecting business scenarios, right? So your cost saving is in terms of time, and overall financial consolidation process is reduced to 6 days from 12 days. That's a cost saving factor. So that's a brief about what is HFM, how does it work, and the training program. I'm stopping here and opening this for your question and answer. If you have any question, you can ask me.